How you doing? Anthony Ferraro here of Create Sci-Fi. Welcome to the seventh video in my series, How to Create a DIY Sci-Fi Short. Today, we're going to talk about crowdfunding. Crowdfunding can be very daunting, but you need a budget. Now, some of you might be here for the first time because you've been searching that very subject, and there's a lot of information out there, but it's scattered, and you're not going to find somebody who's just going to do it for you. Ultimately, what you learn is you have to do it yourself. So let's just do that. I'm going to break it down for you. It's manageable, it's doable. So let's get started. Okay, so first let's determine the amount of money you can realistically raise. You and everyone on your team, the actors, the DP, everyone who are invested in this project need to comb through your personal email lists. Go through your contacts and create a list of people you are very, very sure will donate to you. Go through that list again and be conservative. Highlight only the people that you're sure will donate to you. Now, take that number of people that will most likely donate and multiply that number by $70. This is a very good estimate of how much money you will raise. If you come up with 100 people, that's $7,000. Even if everyone was to give you $200, which is unlikely, that's $20,000. My point is, most likely crowdfunding is not going to raise $200,000 for you. Depending on your network, you can expect to get anywhere from $500 to $10,000. That's reasonable. And next, we're going to look at what platform you want to use. The two majors are Indiegogo and Kickstarter. For a first timer, I recommend Indiegogo because you get whatever you raise regardless of your goal. With Kickstarter, you need to raise 100% of your stated goal to get the funds. People will say by not committing to something scary like an all or nothing proposition is setting yourself up for failure. Which makes no sense to me because of course you don't want to fail. You're going to be working your butt off for a month and you don't want to walk away with nothing. If you're confident that your social network is very strong, then go with Kickstarter. Otherwise, just go with Indiegogo. Either way, use one of those two. While doing all the prep work and leading up to your launch, you want to start seeding your social media. As soon as you start planning and before you launch, create social media accounts around the project. Twitter and Facebook are best because you can have actionable links. Make dedicated accounts for the project, or if you already have a personal account with a large following, start making your crowdfunding part of your daily feed. Replace your banners and avatars with something relating to your project. Post daily about the process. Always include photos and post, post meetings, post rehearsals, concept art, drawings, storyboards, behind the scenes. Document the process to make people aware that you are up to something extraordinary. Now remember, social media postings do not guarantee engagement with your content. However, people are always watching that stream, and your friends and family are guaranteed engagement. Okay, so next we're gonna talk about making the pitch video. The pitch video is pretty straightforward if you follow this structure. Don't wing it, write the script, and I'm gonna share with you some examples from my past campaigns. All right, so basically you wanna start with the intro, the emotional hook. Hi, I'm Anthony Ferraro, and I wanna tell you about my project. For the past year, I've been spending all of my free time and a lot of my not so free time creating a sci-fi series called Galactic Galaxy. And obviously by the title Galactic Galaxy, I'm having a little bit of fun with the genre, but the work I take very seriously. Galactic Galaxy is a sci-fi adventure about an orphan space werewolf who was chosen by the custodian of the galaxy to lead a band of interstellar misfits. Their mission is to save the galaxy from the Dark Huzar. Galactic Galaxy is a sci-fi web series that we shoot live action on a green screen, and we turn it into a very stylized show similar to Rotoscope. But I can't do it alone, and I need your help to build all the sets, to make the costumes, to do all the props, to hire the graphics people, to round up the actors, to rent space. All in is $30,000. With your help and support, it's possible. We have a lot of great rewards for your donations. We have one-of-a-kind production used props. We have DVDs and posters from the short film. We have limited edition signed art prints, large scale and small scale. I need your help to finish Galactic Galaxy. So please donate if you can, share this with your friends. Thank you very much. Now, you probably noticed in that video that I asked for $30,000, which is how I learned all this the hard way. Early on, I got some really great advice, and one person told me about that formula. Go through your email list, and who you think will donate, multiply that by $70. That was sound advice. And for me, I came up with around $12,000 that I could comfortably raise, but I wanted $30,000, and I thought with all my excitement and how awesome my project was, no question I could get the $30,000. And as you see here, I did raise $15,000. I'm proud of that. That was a decent amount of money, and I was able to make my project. However, it was an additional $3,000, not $15,000. So that's why I'm comfortable sharing this advice with you. I have practical experience. As they say, I learned the hard way. All right, so next, this is a very important step that somebody taught me, and it's very valuable. You want to tell them three times. Tell people you're going to tell them, and then tell them that you told them. A week before you launch, you will send one of three emails to your master list of likely donors. In your first email, you will keep it short, talk about what you are about to do, and what day you launch. Ask them straight up if you can count on their support. On average, campaigns that reach their goal raised one-third of their funds within the first quarter of their campaign lifetime. In the email, say something to that effect. The second email you send will be to your entire list, and this is the announcement that it's launch day. You'll also send a separate second email to the people who said they would help get things started, and restate the importance of the first 72 hours to your entire list. The third email you send a few days after the launch to remind people who have not donated yet. And then you launch your campaign. The first 72 hours and the last 72 hours are going to be the busiest. That's all hands on deck. In between then, you'll be doing daily emails, write personal emails asking friends to help. Ask them if they can't help with money to at least post on their social media and share with friends. Then you're going to be posting on Twitter and Facebook daily. Don't put the same image in the same text every day. That looks terrible and it turns people off. You'll have a wall of the same post. What you do is have about a half dozen to a dozen images that pertain to your project. And then your text, the links and the dates will be the same, but do a different opening. Hey guys, happy Friday, that sort of thing. That way it's not a wall. And you're gonna have to coax your cast and crew to post. Remember, it's twice as hard for them to do this. So you just want to remind them, oh, hey, can you post? And then you'll find a couple people will be pretty good at it, and then you'll tend to make that your team. All right, so the next thing you'll be doing, which is very important, is the daily social media thank you. And that's the next step. So let's talk about the social media thank you. Nobody will be too happy if you hijack their social media feed with your crowdfunding promotions. However, when somebody donates, you immediately thank them on social media, tagging them in a post. You say something like, big thank you to Tom, Mary, or JoJo for supporting our project. But most importantly, you add a link to the campaign and that thank you. The link is key. Since you tag them, everyone in their feed is going to see your info and links. They will see a friend of theirs deem this a cool project, so maybe they should check it out. I'll say this again, this is a very important step. All right, so that's a lot of information. But hopefully by now you realize that it's very manageable. And remember, nobody's going to help you with this. And the hard part is a lot of these steps are things you just don't want to be doing. So keep in mind that when you're done with this, you're going to be doing something that you love. And your friends and family will realize that it's something you're passionate about, and it'll probably bother you more than it bothers them. All right, so let's recap. Determine the amount of money you can realistically raise. That's an important one. Choose a platform, Kickstarter or Indiegogo. Start seeding social media, post those pics. Make a pitch video, just follow my outline. Tell them three times, this works. Social media thank you, this will maximize your efforts. Launching a crowdfunding campaign is a huge undertaking. It's good form to run the campaign for at least 30 days, but it's manageable. I like to think of it as you're running for a local office, shaking a lot of hands, kissing babies, one person at a time. If you go at this looking to win over one person at a time, It's 30 days. By the end of it, you'll be successful and you'll be well on your way to making your project. Well, I hope you found this video useful. Please subscribe, share, leave a comment. I'd love to know what you think, and sign up for my email newsletter. And remember, I'm just here to help make sci-fi and crowdfunding for everybody.